Hello, everyone. My name is Michael Heng.
I'm Geraldine Hickey.
Yeah, it is not Mel Buttle, who has abandoned us today, but this is 6 at 6, and we are live from the Imperial Hotel, which is a comedy festival venue. You can go see shows here. I believe there are some...
You can come and see my show here.
For example.
This is one example. There are many great shows on here, which is very exciting. We've got two of the people that are doing shows here. We're going to have a bit of a chat to them. Mm. So you can please welcome Kirsty Wiebeck and Cam Tyson.
Yay! Come in, dudes.
Yeah.
Wait, oh, see, I did not expect...
Shake my hand.
Hello.
Oh, thank you.
Hello, hello. So, you're having a great time.
It's the best handshake I've ever had.
So, Kirsty, you were telling us before that there's been a mix-up with your times and your shows. So what time is your actual show on this year?
Well, it is on at 7.30, but it was supposed to be on at 7.15.
Right.
And on my opening night, I arrived and I said to them, why does it say 7.15 on the board for my show? And they said, because that's the agreement that we had.
Because that's what the contract says.
Exactly. And they very politely went through their emails to show me that that was the agreement.
Right.
Even though we both knew that I was the one who had made the mistake. So now I'm, in fact, on at 7.30. We had to reschedule mine because it had already been registered and advertised at 7.30. Mm. So now mine's on at the same time as Geraldine Hickey's show.
Going head to head.
And it is very confusing for everyone. I mean, our audiences look suspiciously similar, if you know what I mean.
It's
what,
hard
whatever to... Whatever do you mean?
Yeah. Well, I think we share a demo. And there's certain people that come up the stairs and people don't know where they're going.
They've got no idea. Somebody came to my show the other night and said to me, oh, in the foyer, I went to wave to you before the show and then realised I was waving to Geraldine Hickey. Like, we don't look anything alike, but even our own people are confused.
It's the hair.
It's the hair, same barber.
Do you feel like, has anyone come to your show by accident thinking they were at the Geraldine Hickey show or vice versa? Have you seen that yet?
Oh, I have had plenty of walkouts. Like in the first the first 5 minutes going, oh, you're not Kirsty Wiebeck.
Yeah, same. On my opening night, the entire audience got up and left.
Well, we're in the wrong room.
We have also swapped. Yeah.
Like
and
twins.
No one's noticed.
Yeah. Just been doing each other's gear.
Yeah.
And Cam, you're doing a wrestling show, a wrestling podcast right now, yeah?
Yeah, doing a wrestling panel show. It's called WrestleBrania. We bring in actual professional wrestlers to sit alongside comedians. And we talk over the top of each other for an hour. It's a really good time.
Oh, sounds like all podcasts.
Yeah. It's exactly the same as every podcast you've ever listened to.
Also, you're doing your own solo show as well.
I am. A solo show called Mainlander, which starts at the Imperial Hotel here at Tuesday night, April 10th. Runs for 13 nights.
Tell us about the quote that you have from a certain senator.
I got a quote on my poster from Liberal Democrats Senator David Langenhelm calling me a delicate flower because I wrote an article about him that was not very complimentary, and he decided to come at me on Twitter about it, and I responded by calling him, I think the direct quote was, a one-footed seagull with half a brain, and then he blocked me, which is fair enough.
Oh. Yeah.
So just for people watching, to be clear, mostly when comedians put quotes on their posters, it's like a review and it's something positive, or it's like another comedian they might get to say something nice about it. But you've quoted a senator insulting you instead.
Yeah, I got an insult from a senator and a threat of physical violence from a contestant on The Bachelorette. Those are my.
What's all that about?
Oh, that's again less than complimentary things said about him online. And he found the article and did not handle it very well.
Wow.
Yeah.
But you've got some wrestling moves, though, surely?
I got one or two in the bank, yeah.
Have you... is there any chance you could do a little demo?
Do you want to...
Oh, it's certainly on this little nugget over here. That'd be great.
You're offering yourself up, Geraldine, to...
I reckon it's a nice little farewell for you.
Right. Yeah, no, okay. So what are we doing here?
Sort of, like, we'll hold you there like that, and then one arm will come up here,
okay.
And one arm, and then
you're
we'll just
right?
sort of lock that in.
No, that doesn't move now.
Yeah,
that's...
You're pretty
stuck. That's a no, full Nelson.
I mean, are you okay? Yeah.
No, well,
can you breathe in?
Yeah, this is no good. This is really no good.
Do you know what?
How do you feel about that?
Oh, it's so crook. It's
excellent.
So crook.
Hinks, I'm sure you've had a terrific time doing this. Thank you so much for your service.
It has been a real joy.
This is your last one.
Yes, it is. It is. It is. So let's excuse, I guess, and thank you guys so much for being here.
Thank you for having us.
And we'll go through the news and stuff as you guys
enjoy.
Thank you. Go see their shows, everyone. Just some stuff to update you on, Jez. You're going to go through the news at the end of the show every day.
Thank you for the hot tips.
Update, right? Filming, Up Late is filming tomorrow from 6 at the Hi-Fi Club or Max Watts, but tonight, house party's on, so people can get along to that. You can see probably Andrew McClellan's DJing it, probably D-Rotten Punk Day hosting it, I assume. It's always fun. It's full of carnies. But like you were saying, next week I'm back because I'm done with the festival. I'm back home. And Hickey, you're going to be taking this over.
I'll be taking it over along with Guy Montgomery. So
he's a very charming individual.
He's very, very good.
I'd say significantly more charming than I am.
Yeah, you're very charming.
Oh, thank you.
And also thanks to Melinda Buttle for doing this as well. It's been great. See you all next week.
So, yeah, bye.